Class, we will discuss the boundary conditions at interfaces. Like interfaces means, suppose there are two mediums are there, one medium you can consider this side and another medium you can consider this side. It's like say you are having two medium, and what will be the conditions or properties of the electric and magnetic field if there are two mediums are present, right? That means the electromagnetic wave which will be coming, or suppose it is incident in this kind of situation or circumstances or conditions, what will be the property of the electric field and magnetic field if there are two different mediums are present, and what will be the condition of or the property of electric field and magnetic field at the interface between the two medium one and medium two, right? So you can consider this figure as, this is our one medium one. This side, left hand side, you can consider is medium one. Medium one is defined by A, F, E, B, right? This one, this part is your medium one, and medium two you can consider E, D, C, B. So this is your medium two. There are two separate mediums we can consider. Now we will see what are the properties of this electric and magnetic field in these two medium. So first we need to know what are the boundary conditions that we have. So there are two separate boundary conditions. One is boundary conditions for electric field, another is boundary condition for magnetic field. So we let us see one by one what are the conditions, right? So the first condition that we will discuss is the boundary condition is E tan 1 equals to E tan 2. That means tangential component of electric field at the medium 1 will be equal to the tangential component of electric field at medium 2. So here 1 and 2 are medium. Tan is like your tangential component, and E is the electric field. So the first boundary condition states that the tangential component of electric field at medium 1 will be equal to tangential component of electric field at medium 2, right? So for this purpose we will define certain things in this medium 1 and medium 2. So suppose we consider a rectangular loop. Here the loop means, I'm talking about the medium, rectangular loop with del x, right? So del x, I'm taking this as del x. Rectangular width of the rectangular loop is del x, that is f to d. This total, if I can draw like this, so you can say that this f to d, let us consider as del x, right? Now also length del y. Suppose we take this length del y on boundary of medium 1 and medium 2, right? So length we are taking del y. Del y means, if I can extend this one like this, so this is your del y, right? This is the length, so we are considering this del x here, the width, and length as del y, right? So now let us see, if this is the condition, so we can very easily denote that if this is total length is del y, we can consider that the electric field at this one, at this side from A to F, since this is the, you see there is x and this is y, so you can say, you can define this is as EY1 is in this direction, right? And EY2 is in this direction, right? And also we can write del x by 2, this half part, that is A to B or F to E, this is del x by 2. Why? Because the total we have considered as del x, so half of what this total length is, we are considering as del x by 2. Right, now let us see. Now we know E field is conservative in nature. E field is conservative in nature. Conservative. Okay, so if E field is conservative, that means EDL, closed line integral of EDL will be equals to 0. So this is the condition that we know, because that E field is conservative in nature, right? So if this is the case, we can also define this term as, EX1 this part, right? This is your E x2, right? X1 and x2, because in x direction we are separating and dividing two different mediums are there. So it is E x1, yes, just E x1 and x2 we are defining, and also we can define it at E x3, and this is E x4, right? This part. Okay, so we have already defined all the terms. So let us see. Now, since this E field is conservative, we can write that total or the closed line integral of E dl throughout closed line integral means that if we start from any of the point, if we go from here to here, then here, then here, then here, and go, that means that we are considering the closed line integral throughout the two different mediums, it will be equals to zero. Okay, so the electric field is, since the electric field is conservative in nature. So now let us evaluate this term first. So this term will be equals to, from this figure we can write EDL equal to EX1 A to B DL. So this is EX1 means A to B. Let us start from here, this point. So EX1 A to B is EX1 integral of A to B DL, right? So next we can write EX2. X2 will be from B to C DL plus then C to D. C to D is equals to EY2 C to D DL, right? Now, so this field lines of force are not lines of force actually, I mean direction of this are opposite in direction. So next we can write this as minus EX4. So this minus term comes because of the opposite direction. AEX4 D2 D2 E DL minus of EX3 E2F, C is here, E2F DL minus EY1 F to A DL, right? This will be the total closed line integral, and that will be equals to zero since this is equals to zero. So we can also consider that from this part to this part, you can take the minus common and all this will be positive, right? For the next, for another medium, right? So now we can evaluate this one. We can certainly have this EX1 del x by 2. Simply I am putting the value of DL here. This is del x by 2. This length is del x by 2 plus EX2 del x by 2 plus EY2 del y. Here it is length, I mean C to D is del y, as I said. So del y minus EX4 del x by 2 minus EX, this is EX, this is EX4 minus EX3 del x by 2 minus EY1 del y1 del y, that is equals to 0, right? So now this del x, I mean del x, total overall del x, since we are considering that this del x is very small in nature, I mean if we are considering two different medium at the interface, since we are bothered about the interface only, we can very easily consider that this total overall width of this section and this section is very small. So that means this del x is very small. We can consider this del x tends to 0. So now, since del x tends to 0, so finally you put the values of del x in this expression, you will get E y2 del y minus E y1 del y equals to 0, and finally E y2 equals to E y1. Thus, that means, therefore, that means E of tan 1 equal to E of tan 2. So hence, this is the proof of the first boundary condition between the two medium, right? This is the next boundary condition at the interfaces, as you can see. Number two boundary condition that we will have is dN1 equals to dN2, right? So this will be the second boundary conditions for interfaces, where you can see there is a cylindrical surfaces there, and this blue line is your separation between the two medium. You can consider the top part as medium one, and you can consider bottom part as your medium two, where this del s is the surface and del s is also here the surface, and this side
length, I mean the height is, suppose we are denoting it by del x. So the condition is dn1 is equal to dn2. So you can very easily remember, I mean, apply the Gauss law here. So applying Gauss law, this is actually we need to prove, applying Gauss law at the boundary, we will know that Gauss law at the boundary is rho dv is equals to q, right? Now when there is no charge at the surface, I mean here at the surface we consider there is condition, that means there are no charges present, right? So that means in that case q will be, this q will be equals to zero. So we can write that when there is no charge at the surface, q will be equals to zero. Then if q equal to zero, if this q equal to zero, then surface charge density rho s is also zero. So therefore we can write surface charge density rho s will also equals to zero, right? So if this is the condition, then we can finally write from this expression, we can write therefore integral of ds will be equals to zero, since this equals to zero and this equals to zero. So we can write this. So from here we can write for different medium d of n1 ds minus d of n2 ds will be equals to zero, or therefore finally we can write dn1 equal to dn2, and hence the second boundary conditions is proved. Now one simple point I need to tell you, that sometime they ask you to only write the boundary conditions for electric field or magnetic field. So in that case you only write the boundary conditions, like E tan 1 equal to E tan 2. This is the, these two are actually boundary conditions related to electric fields. So one is E tan 1 equal to E tan 2, another you write that dn1 equal to dn2. So these are the two conditions. Sometimes if they ask only for to write the boundary conditions, you need to write only these two. And if sometimes they ask to prove the boundary conditions, then the two that prove that I have done, so these two prove, you can separately study also. And also the similar boundary conditions are there in case of magnetic field, like H tan 1 equals to H tan 2. So let us see then, I mean let us see those things in details, right?
Another boundary conditions related to the magnetic field. So this condition is just similarly we have discussed in our previous discussion. This condition is actually H tan 1 equal to H tan 2. H tan 1 equal to H tan 1 tan 2, right? So just similarly the magnetic field tangential component of magnetic field at medium 1 will be equal to the tangential component of magnetic field at medium 2. See, this figure which I have discussed is similar to that of we discussed E tan 1 equal to E tan 2. So that we have discussed, the figure is similar, somewhat similar, only P in place of E we have written as H, right? Magnetic field, all these are same. This part you can consider medium 1, this part you can consider medium 2. Total length is, suppose I mean width is dx, so half of the width is dx by 2 or del x by 2, and this is the length which is denoted by d del y, and these are the directional field component of different directions in the boundary interfaces, right? So to prove this, we can also sometimes they ask to prove this H tan 1 equal to H tan 2. So we will simply apply Maxwell's fourth equations, right? So let us start from there, applying Maxwell's fourth law. What is fourth law? That is modified Ampere circuit law, right? Modified Ampere circuit law. So this law will apply. So this law, as you know, that this is closed line integral of HDL will be equals to surface integral of J plus del D del T ds, right? This was the modified Ampere circuit law. Now we will prove, just as we did in our case of electric boundary conditions at the interface, we'll similarly have from this expression we can write this, we'll evaluate this part, left hand side only, that is the closed line integral of magnetic field from A to B, then B to C, from C to D, D to E, E to F, and again F to A. So this part, if we can evaluate, so we will get the overall or closed line integral of magnetic field. And if we can, from here we can easily prove that H tan 1 equal to H tan 2. So let us evaluate this left hand part, left hand side, right? So this will be equals to, this left hand side will be equals to H of X1, this from A to P first. So H of X1, A to B, DL plus then this one B to C. So B to C, oh wait 1 minute, H X2, B to E, B to C actually, right? DL plus H Y2, C to D, DL, right? And next we will have minus, as you know, minus whole you can take all positives, only the difference you can take. So this minus H X4, D to E, DL plus D to E I have taken, now E to F, minus H X3, E to F, DL minus H Y1, F to A, DL. This is the left hand side, and that will be equals to integral of J Z plus of D DZ DT DS, right? Where Z is the direction of propagation of magnetic fields, you know, that since these are, I mean, electric field, then magnetic field wise we are considering Z, we are considering because electric field and magnetic field are always perpendicular to each other, right? So now just simply we will put, I mean, we will evaluate these integrals functions, and we will ultimately arrive at H X1 DX by 2 plus H X2 DX by 2 plus H Y2 del Y minus H X4 del X by 2 minus H X3 del X by 2 minus H Y1 del Y, that will be equals to JZ plus D DZ DT DX DY. Right, so let us consider that our as equation one. So if this is the case, now you will know that simply this del x is tends to zero. Now therefore we can write, now since del x tends to zero, we can easily, you will put the values of del x everywhere, and you will finally arrive at h y2 minus h y1 is equals to zero. So from here therefore we can write h of tan 1 equal to H of tan 2, right? So this is the proof of the boundary condition related to magnetic field, where H T1 equal to H tan 2. So this is similar to that of the, I mean, electric field boundary conditions. So if they ask for proof, so up to this will be okay, right?